Fujifilm 27mm on Fujifilm X-Pro3. Let's talk about this lens after using it for 1 year. Hi there, my name is Tudor Matescu and in this video I will talk about the Fujifilm 27mm Mark II lens after using this lens almost a year. So, please subscribe to my channel for more videos and content like this about Fujifilm and camera gear. Also check my Fujifilm analog experience and my review about XC4 to see what I have to say about Fujifilm cameras in general. And also I do recommend my 18mm f2 review. So let's get into the subject. Why this lens? Because it's a 40mm equivalent full frame lens. It has the field of view of a 40mm lens. More exactly 41mm. And I really like that focal length. I really do like that focal length very much. Why? Because it is a 35 with plus more millimeters, so I get a little more compression, I get a little narrow field of view, but not so narrow. With this focal length, I can do the photography that I do with a 35mm lens, but better composed. And also, with this focal length, I can do the photography that I do with a 50mm lens. So this is a very versatile field of view. And being a pancake lens and weather sealed, it is no-brainer for the Fujifilm system. But this lens has some problems and has some advantages. I want to talk in this video about this. I will start with what I don't like about this lens. But bear in mind that I really recommend this lens. And why I do that, it is at the second part of the video, check the chapters of this video. So, let's start with what I don't like about this lens. And even if there are lots of points comparing to other lenses reviews that I've done, I really recommend this lens because it is the only 40mm lens on the Fujifilm system. So, what I don't like about this lens? I don't like the minimum focus distance. It is not sufficient. It is 0.34 meters, so 34 centimeters. It's not enough. I don't feel it. It isn't sufficient. And for a lens that you can use to get up close, because you can do this with this focal lens, with this field of view, having just 34 centimeters minimum focus distance, it's not something that it is very welcome. So, minimum focus distance could be better. Also, I don't like the fact that it is just f2.8 lens. It's not enough to have sufficient light for night photography. Yes, you can do it. Yes, go with the ISO at 1218 and you can make some photos with lots of noise in them. Also, in interiors, in normal bright interiors, it's not sufficient. Your ISO will be very bumped or you must lower the shutter speed very much. Not having IBIS on Fujifilm X-Pro3 or XC4 and so on. So, big problem with the aperture. Also, this aperture with this pancake lens is not sufficient for good portraits. Just if you have good light or if you know how to control the light, you will get good portraits, but this is not because of the lens. It's because of you that you know what to do with the light. Also, another thing that I don't like, I feel it doesn't have sufficient contrast and resolution like the 50mm or the 35mm f2 lens. So it's not a very contrasty lens. I don't know for sure about the resolution. Maybe it will have resolution for a 40 megapixel sensor, but the contrast, it isn't there. Also, this lens has some flare. I like the flare. It's okay, but there are situations where I wouldn't want that flare. It wasn't something that it bothered me very much, because I use this lens for street photography and for documenting my life, and I like some flare. But I really would have loved a more controlled flare, a more contrasty looking images from this lens. It isn't at the level of the 35mm f2 lens, or at the 50mm, or even at the 18mm f2 lens. What a pretty size lens, and I really like it. Also, I don't recommend this lens for landscapes, because the 40mm field of view for landscapes, I personally don't feel it. And also because, how I have said, regarding the resolution and the image quality of this lens, you don't have that pop, that color that you are used to when we are talking about Fujifilm lenses. Just now I've looked on the MTF charts, and I see that the MTF charts are showing what I am telling about this lens. It does have good resolution and good contrast. That resolution and that contrast and sharpness of the lens, it is just in the center of the lens. So you could argue this is because it is a pancake lens, and it is true. But I feel that Fujifilm could have done a better job. They could have at least built this lens a little bigger, like 18mm f2 lens, and give us a better image quality. I don't feel the micro contrast in this lens. For a long time I've used this lens, the 20mm pancake lens, on a Lumix GX9, and this, I feel, it is a better lens, or it is at the same level. This has a minimum focus distance, an excellent minimum focus distance, and also an f1.8 aperture, so I can get more light with this lens. So I'm really disappointed. I would have hoped for a better 40mm lens from Fujifilm comparing to a Micro Four Thirds lens. But let me tell you why I like this lens and why I still using it. So I really like it because it is very, very small. It is very light. It is a pancake, a truly pancake lens. I like the fact that it is weather sealed. So this weather sealed lens on this weather sealed body, I have a weather sealed camera, so I can take this setup and make pictures. And the image quality for this lens, it is sufficient for street photography and documentary photography. And this is where this lens shines. Being so small, being so unobtrusively, being so easy to carry, you can put this lens on XC4 or on X-Pro3 and go out shooting all day long. And also when the night comes, you can bypass that f2.8 aperture by being attentive, lower your shutter speed and bump up the ISO, and this is it. I like to use this lens in conjunction with the Fujifilm 35mm f1.4 lens when it is darker outside. But for daylight use, I really do prefer this setup, because the ergonomics are here. The viewfinder frame lines are beautiful. It's like a perfect match with Fujifilm X-Pro3, and also it's a perfect match with Fujifilm XC4. So it is a very versatile lens, all on X-Pro3 and on XC4. Even if it flares, the flare, it's nice. I like it. I like what I can obtain with the flare, and I'm showing you pictures with the flare from this pancake lens. And so this small disadvantage, you can use it for your photography. Also, I like the AF, the autofocusing. It is pretty good, not as good as the 35mm f2 or the f2 versions of Fujifilm lenses, but not as bad and clunky as the 35mm f1.4 or 18mm f2. They don't have bad AF, that lenses, but their AF, it is pretty loud. This has some sounds too, but not so loud as the 35mm f1.4 or the 80mm f2. The sound of the AF motor of this lens is between the sound of the 35mm f2 and the 35mm f1.4. So it will not bother you, it will not bother your subject, and it's pretty fast, so you will not have problems focusing with this lens. Also, I've tested the AFC, autofocus continuous, in a video. I don't use it in a photo, but I've tested it now for photography, and I feel it is good, it is there. It is better than the 35mm f1.4 or the 80mm f2. Regarding the build quality of this lens, I really like it. It has nice clicks, it has aperture lock, it is very small, weather resistant, it's feeling sturdy, and it really makes your camera an everyday camera. So this is why I've chose to use this lens. In conclusion, even if I have lots of disappointed points regarding this lens, for what it is and for the cost that it has, and better if you find this lens on the used market, I really think it deserves a place in your kit. For myself, I really like to shoot the 40mm field of view lens, and I really like pancake lenses. But especially I really like 40mm pancake lenses, because a 40mm field of view, how I have said in the starting of this video, it allows you to get close to your subject, to have a 35mm kind of lens and kind of view, so you can compose images easier. You can get good compositions with this lens easier than a 35mm lens. So this lens, it's between the 35 and the 50mm field of view. So this is why I really like it. As I have said, even if I don't like the image quality of this lens, the image quality, it is sufficient. This is a very fun lens to use. It is a very beautiful lens. It is a lens that will make your camera not bother you when you have your camera on you or in your camera bag. So the fan factor with this lens, it is strong. If you want to buy this lens, buy it not for the image quality, but buy it for what it will offer you. It will offer you the 40mm field of view, a beautiful field of view, a very versatile field of view. It will give you portability, it will give you weather sealing. So very, very versatile. So, I really recommend this lens. Don't expect excellent image quality. Don't expect the contrasty look that you know from Fujifilm. But if you edit RAW files and you do the right settings on your JPEG files, you will get good images. In the end, it's about the light and the editing of the image. This editing you can do on your RAW files or directly on your JPEG files from your Fujifilm camera. The picture that I've showed you in this video are made with this lens, some are JPEGs straight from the camera, and some are edited RAW files. And from my experience, I was able to get with this lens the images that I wanted to get. I felt in the editing process, I'm not there as I am with a better lens, but working that sliders, I was able to get good images and also good printed images. So it's a lens that will deliver the images that you want if you know to work that images. I really recommend it. It will offer you an experience, a beautiful experience. And this is why I still use this lens on my Fujifilm camera. It is a lens that I really like to have it, to use it, to work the scene with this lens. It is a beautiful, beautiful combination, and I get the images. It's not always about the image quality. If I want better image quality, I will use another lens. But for fun, street photography, documenting my family, documenting my life, I don't have a problem with this lens. I always get good images with this lens, but I am attentive to the settings, to the JPEG settings or to the light or to the ISO, so I can get some good quality in my files. Thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel. Check the links from the description and from the comments for more relevant information about this lens and about my activity. Thank you for watching it and talk to you soon. Bye bye.